Craig asked me if I can talk about how to draw boats. Craig, this one's for you. What's up, friends? Liron here. Welcome to another video. I hope you're all doing great. As I said, in this video, we will be looking at how to draw boats, and I'm just gonna present you with like 7 different examples of how I approach a specific boat in a specific angle, a specific type of boat. We'll even throw in a ship just for fun. So let's get to it. First boat. Okay, so here's the first boat we're gonna be looking at, and I hope you can see this well. I actually chose this one because it's fairly simple. Now, the boat itself is not that simple necessarily, but what's simple is the shape, because it's really just all dark black because of the lighting conditions, so we can kind of look at its contours and outline and just draw the outline. Okay, so let's start with like the line that seems most obvious to me, at least. So I'm just gonna pull down. It's kind of hard to understand how much space I have here. Let's do it like that, and I'm just going to pull down a line at approximately the angle in which I see it for the front sort of piece of wood that just stands up like that. And I'm just trying to map out the shape, like the general, very general shape of this boat thingy. Now, because of the place where the boat touches the water, because there's this area here, it just makes a flat bottom line, and this is what we want to get here. I'm using a really, really light pencil. It's like 6H, so just so that I can plan this carefully and not ruin it or something. I'm really drawing at an angle that I'm not used to drawing, because the paper is under me. I'm actually standing up right now. It's a bit weird. I'm used to only paint like that, but we will see how it goes. I was asked about drawing boats, and I just decided, you know what, I'm just going to give many examples. I think it's the best thing I can do here. Now, when I look at this edge, there's a line going out like that at a slight angle. Now, this line reaches somewhere around here, and at about the center point, we have this line coming out of that, okay? So it's going kind of even a bit taller, I'd say, and just connects the two like this. And I know you can barely see this, but I'm gonna make the lines a little stronger in a few moments. And sorry about the changing lighting conditions. I'm using natural light, and I just find it like a billion times better. But it also kind of holds me back, because I can't really do these videos at night or after there's not enough sun outside, because I don't like the artificial light in my room, so I kind of prefer not to do that. Now, we have this sort of thing here that just comes out a bit like that. I'm not really sure what it is, but you don't really need to get all the details in perfectly. This is just like the, not shadow, but rather, you know, I forgot the word. Someone leave a comment saying what it's called when you only see like a black thingy. Yeah, I'm really bad at words, but you get the point. This is sort of the engine, I think, or I don't know if there's an engine, because it's like a rowboat. I don't know. It may be a rowboat, or like maybe it has the oars just for backup, because I do see an oar going that way. So maybe it's just a backup oar. I don't know. Maybe you don't really have to use it. And this is another backup oar. And now there's this sort of a thing casting a shadow, I guess, on the passengers, boat riders. And there are a few wiry thingies here. And I'm really not trying to just stick super close to the reference. I'm just kind of winging it, actually. So let's just go over some of the key lines here, just to make it look a little more
clear to see. We have this plank kind of thing here. We've got that fake ore on the left. We have this line where it touches the water surface. And actually there's also the shadow, and it's very subtle, but I'm just gonna do that just to indicate it's there somewhere. Like this. Actually, I used to love pencil, and then I kind of stopped using it only as a drawing, as a basis for paintings now. Nowadays, mostly I use pen. But yeah, it's nice once in a while to go back to some pencil work, you know. I always felt like it's so much work just to get something to look good with the pencil, because it doesn't feel like it's finalized, and then you have to keep adding stuff, and I don't know, I just never really liked that. It may be a bit stupid, I don't know, but it's how I feel. Anyway, this is the first boat, and I think I'll just go through a time-lapse of me darkening this whole thing, because I want to move on to the next one, because there's like 7 of them. So let me do that in time-lapse, and I'll be back, and we can move on to the next one. So there you have it, a very simple boat, but you gotta start somewhere. I just added a bit of a hint of reflections. I'm using a textured Arche paper for sketching, and so you can see this funny cool texture here. May not be perfect for this kind of work, by the way. You may wanna use a smoother surface, but I love it. I just love that texture. Anyway, let's move on to the second boat. Okay, now we are in the... So with this boat, we're really in the big league, because this one has this annoying angle that kind of wants to, kind of makes you wanna kill yourself, because it's like foreshortening. So you have the boat from the side, and it's nice. It looks like this. It's really cool. And then you turn it around like that, and we see the pointy end here and the pointy back there, and it's... Anyway, let's get to it. Let's do our best. So I'm gonna start with what's actually a little easier here, which is the front part. And we have this curvy curve here. And already I can tell you I hate that boat and that picture. I mean, it's a beautiful picture, no offense to the person who took it. I just hate it. Anyway, so I'm just indicating this line. It's also against the natural curve of my wrist. So just as a side note, it's really easier to do these kinds of lines when it's with the curve, but now we have one that's against the curve, so that's just perfect. I gotta stop complaining. So we got this line here. Now we're gonna pull another one from this one, and you can see it sort of curves like that. Now the thing is, there is a nice trick to this kind of things. You sort of want to make an 8 figure, kind of like that. Actually, no, that's not good. It's not good. It worked for someone else, though. I saw it somewhere. You see this curve here at the end? This is the tricky part, I guess, because you want to be able to convey the shape of the boat. So anyway, it curves right here, and then it goes back ever so slightly to the front and comes back towards here. Okay, so we do have an 8 figure with one pointy end here. I'm just gonna mark it like that. There's a huge B outside the window. So I'm just gonna mark it like that, and this is the second one. These are the edges, and from the edges you get this sort of an 8 shape, and right back to the front like that, okay? So we got this in. Now we wanna get the side of the boat. Another part that may be a bit tricky. Now because of the distance, it's sort of, it's in perspective. So we don't pull this line all the way to the same line as this one. We stop somewhere at a taller spot. And from that, we drop a very curved line that meets this end. See this one here? And on the other side, we do the same, only it's a different angle. And so it's a little simpler. Okay, and this is the essence of this boat. Let me move the page a little bit and zoom out. Sorry about the shakiness, but now you can see the rest is just filling in the details here. So we have this cabin thingy here, like that. Somewhere around here, we've got that front shape here, like a square, like a table, like I don't know what it is, like quarters for the fishermen or whatever, whoever they are. I don't know who uses this kind of boat. You tell me. So I think this is pretty good now. There's this change in color here like that I want to get in. Now what I'm going to do is just go in, time-lapse the hell out of this. Use the different darker pencil just to bring in some of the details. But the main shape, this is how you do it. Okay, let's get to it. So this is it for this one. I'm just gonna shade in some of the areas just to give it a little more context, a little more meaning to it, I guess. So you see, when you just start with a basic shape that's correct, it's much easier to continue and add on the details on top of it. But I can understand, sometimes it's really difficult to grasp sort of the shape when you just begin. So the 8 trick can help here, but what can really help is just generally working on your observation skills and understanding how to translate what you see to paper. So you have this visual language, which is a means to draw something, to represent something on paper according to what you see. And for me, with drawing or with pen, things of that nature, it's really easier to do that. But with watercolor, which I'm relatively new at, it's a bit more challenging, you know, because there's actually like, how do you convey something that you want to show? Because sometimes it's really easy to sort of see the reference and kind of understand what it is, what it looks like, but then when you try to put it on paper, disaster ensues, you know. So it's just I think a lot of work and a lot of observation, and maybe a lot of observation of other people's work. Anyway, we are done with this one. Let's jump right into the next one, because we have so many to cover, and I'm gonna do obviously the next ones a little faster than these ones. So let's get to it. So friends, I promised a ship and I deliver. Here we have one. And it's exactly the same thing, in fact. It's not that complicated. All you have to do is understand the basic large shape here. And when you do such a large object, when you want to draw it, you just have to really understand what you want to include and what stays out of the sketch. So here we go. This is the front part, this pointy part here. And the bottom, as before, it's just actually a flat line, because it's where the water meets the body of the boat, of the ship, rather. And so it's a simple shape. So we have it like that. Now, from here, we have this sort of a curvy line that goes like that. And actually, we have that exact 8 shape we've just seen, but it's much more subtle in this example. So no use of even trying to get it, because it's like there is this sort of a loop going on here, but yeah, it's just so subtle. We aren't even gonna try. I'm just gonna get a curved line to connect to this area, like this. And actually, so much of the ability to draw such things just comes from the ability to understand at which angle your hand can actually draw specific lines, because some lines are really difficult in certain angles, and you kind of have to learn how your hand functions. So we have this. Now this is the edge here. This is the other edge, and this is the front edge. And from that point, we have this sharp point, and it goes back round like this, but we don't see all of this part because of all of the masts and the details, which I'm gonna add now. So I'm just gonna pull a few lines indicating where they're gonna be. We have, I think, the 1, 2, 3, at the back, and this is it. So from these lines, you want to pull out the mast shapes, and it's sort of a trapezoid, I guess. So we have the front one here. Like that. Something like this. We have another one here next to it. And I'm gonna make all these lines darker, so don't worry about that. You'll have to excuse me because I'm really rusty at making the pencil videos. I'm so used to the ink things and spontaneous sketching. It's been a while actually since I did a video with pencil, so I don't really remember exactly how well you can see this and all this stuff, so I'm kind of relearning it, and I'll probably do a lot more of these in the future, so that you will improve with time. Again, not my biggest passion, pencil specifically. So now that we are done with this, we can just go ahead and go over all of these lines, add some shading. I'll do that all in time lapse. But as you can see, the shape is sort of similar. It's like this very same 8 that connects like this. So that's all there is to it, basically. Let's do this in time lapse and then move on. We've got like 4 more. Okay, so I just gave an indication of most of the important details. We do have some of the structures sort of inside the ship in the center, but we won't really be able to see most of them here. So I'm just gonna leave them like this. And now we have the fun part, which is all the those little ropes here coming at different directions. And you just want to look at the reference and understand where the ropes are coming from, where they're moving. And especially if you're doing this like the first example we did, which got a bit smeared, sorry, but just dark, then you will especially be able to tell these ropes, especially against a contrasting light background. Okay, so now we have a few that are running around to the front here. And it's really cool, anything that you want to try and draw, you can find reference for like everything. So you can just open Google Images or Pixabay, which is the website I used for these images, and just go at it. So now I'm just marking where some of the shaded areas on the masts are going to be. And really, because it's just simple sketches, I'm not devoting too much time for that, but kind of the light comes from the front, I guess, a bit from the top, because this part is white and this bottom part is shaded. So what happens is this mast blocks the light from getting to the back, to the backmost mast, and this is what happens. There are some creases here, very gentle, maybe a few here as well. And you can kind of darken the entire body of the ship. Let me do that real quick in time lapse, sort of try and get the values right and wrap up this example. So this is it for this one. I just made this hull, or I don't know how you call it, hull, like darker. Added this improvised ledge here, and this is it. Let's move on to the next one. So sometimes you also get one of these super annoying foreshortened angles. And as I said before, so if you have sort of the boat like that, and then you bring it completely forward, you get this weird foreshortening effect. So let's try and get that in. We can start with the front shape because that's the easiest part. It's just an upside down trapezoid. I love that word, trapezoid. Just makes you sound smart, even though it's really simple, I think. So I'm adding in just the trapezoid shape. And as you'll soon see, it's much simpler than it appears to be. This entire shape, you just kind of have to notice the relations, okay? It can be a little tricky. So if I look at the very tip of the boat, I can see that it's about the same area as this one if I go from right to left. And it's a bit above, so I'm just going to mark this dot here. Okay. Now, with this one, it's pretty easy to connect them. And you know what? I'm going to make it a little higher like that because I notice it's about the equivalent of this. This is what you want to do, basically. You just want to break down the object into simpler relations and lengths and stuff like that, just to understand it. So I'm just trying to locate that tip here, and it's about the same height as this part. So somewhere around here, and it's above this point. Perhaps a little lower, like that. The second one I did was good. So to connect it to this one, it's fairly simple. You just sort of pull a curved line like that, okay? Now, to get it connected to this one, we have this strange curve. Now, it would be beneficial to kind of understand the relations between the right side and this side. So it appears to me like the distance to here is about halfway through this distance. So we have, this is half, we have another one here. Okay, and what we do is we actually draw a curve that goes through this point like that, with the edge point being this one. Okay, so we connected these two lines, and now we have another line that's sort of, this one should be a little like this, less angle, but this one is more at an angle. So we get this weird shape going on. And lo and behold, we have that that little boat down. And it was much simpler than you would think when you actually try to find the relations between the lines and stuff like that. So we have this small sort of seat here and this indication of the center point. And let's say the light comes from the left, so this area will be shaded. And also this inner area will be shaded as well. And we'll have this sort of shadow moving to the left here. And hopefully you can see this. It's a bit, should have probably left some white gap here. Let's try and do that now. So I'm gonna draw this line, leave a small white gap. And with the ocean in the background, it's a little darker. It should become a little clearer to see the separation. It's a bit complicated because of the rough texture, so I'm a bit struggling here, but I can just go ahead and erase a bit more and sort of show that these two are connected, and now it's a little more clear. So when you have the ocean like that, the waves, the water is darker, and so you get this sort of a shape here. So hopefully you can understand what I did here. It's a bit of a tricky angle. We have this also pipe going on, running from here all across this right side section. And we have another one doing the exact same thing on the other side, which I'm not going to draw probably. Just maybe let's hint that it exists. It moves like that, and it's even darker than the water. So hopefully you can understand what I did here. Not necessarily the best way to finish this one, but I think it's pretty clear, yeah. So it's a really weird angle, but as the more you are able to treat it like what you see is what you get, and sort of find the relations between this pointy edge and this point, and sort of be really scientific about it, you'll get it right. Okay, so this is like the main point here. Anyway, let's move on to the next one. So I thought it would be cool to show one boat at an angle that's a bit lower compared to the previous ones. So we have a very similar angle to actually the second example, but it's still a bit different, so I wanted to share it. So I'm going to start again with this middle section. By the way, sharpening the pencil helps. And then I'm going to do just like we did earlier, pull out this line all the way to the back and sort of finish it like that. Just going with my gut here. Then I can pull down a line like this and bring it all the way to meet this one here at the front. Yeah, kind of through the lines all over the place, but you get it, it's this one. Now on the other edge, we have the exact same thing we had earlier, like this. And this basically closes off that. But what's interesting is actually this inner part, because we're looking at it from a lower angle, So because we're looking at it from a lower angle, we don't have a straight line here. We don't have like a line that moves down. We have a line that goes up like this, diagonally. And then it goes a bit down like that. And oh man, and then it moves again like this. And it sort of curves like that all the way down here. And here we have this line that goes like this. And this area is divided into windows. Just before that, I'm gonna get the roof in. This area is divided to windows. We have three of them. So that's like one, two, three, like this. And also the side here is divided into two windows. And you can kind of see how that works. Very similar to the second example, only we have that added sort of dimension of we're looking at it from a lower angle. So with the lower angle, this is sort of what happens, okay? Just wanted to show this as a quick example, really similar again to this one, only looking at it from a lower angle, okay? And of course, when you add the shading and all of that good stuff, then you can really get the shape to look better. So if light comes from the left, we would first darken this area here that's much more obscure, and then we can also gradually darken this one, and because it's a bit round, we'll slowly drop some of the pressure. This one also gets the dark treatment like this, and you can also already feel kind of its shape. We have the bottom part here that's also a little darker. Some of the, could be cool to get some of the rusty areas here, sort of because it was wet and we got some of the metal to rust. This is it, just really similar to the previous example we saw. Let's look at yet another one. Okay, so I wanted to also show you this one, and it's a bit at a different angle, much more from the front. So we have this center line that's really almost vertical, but we will make it a bit diagonal to the bottom right. Now, we have this line that sort of meets it almost horizontally, but sort of goes downwards a bit. And these are the things you want to really pay attention to. In my course, this is exactly what I talk about, because these are the skills that kind of, you know, you can learn how to draw boats, you can learn how to draw trees, you can learn how to draw specific things, but just developing your observational skills and understanding of three-dimensional objects will help you to draw just anything from observation, you see? So this is exactly what I work on in my course. I'll add a link in the description below. It's really, I think, one of the most important skills to just be able to do. And because, I don't know why what happened with me, but somehow I'm able to do that since I'm young. Now, even if my technique is not perfect at times, or, you know, you can see I'm a bit rusty with the pencil, I can still get what I look at, okay? So if I look at a boat, I can sort of understand its shape and translate it to the paper. And I think that's really an important skill. Okay. Anyway, I just added this this left side because it's a bit more far away from us. It's turning to the left, so we see less of it. It just gets more squished. And we have this sort of ledge here, I guess, so that people don't fall off. And we're just pulling it all the way parallel to these lines, which makes it really simple. Parallel lines is like my favorite. It really makes everything so much easier. And just getting the basic shape of it here. You can see, probably, my technique is a bit rusty with the pencil, but in terms of being able to actually draw what I see, portray it, it's really a completely different skill set. And if you learn like something extra from this video, I think it's that, you know, you can have a really good understanding of what you see Even if your technique is not perfect. I mean, you can look at it in a negative light as well. You can say, well, even if my technique is really good and I have good control over the pencil, if I don't understand what I see, and if I'm not able to translate it to actually a drawing, then that's also a downside, you know. But I like to look at the positive. So the positive here is really technique will come, you know. We're all gifted, you know, we all have basic coordination, even if you think you don't. You know, even if you've never really took drawing, you never really tried to do that, just maybe in kindergarten, you know, it doesn't matter. We all have the same hands, the same brains. It's just a matter of, you know, practicing and working on it, just like driving, you know, when you learn how to drive. You don't know how to drive in the beginning, and you need to have something that's very challenging in the beginning, like the coordination, doing all the things simultaneously, paying attention to stuff on the street, and, you know, all the manual things you have to do, changing gears if it's manual, and getting really specific with this example. But the point is that in the beginning, it's really hard, and once you get it, it's much simpler. Like right now, I'm working on learning how to play a music from Game of Thrones. And in the beginning, on the piano. In the beginning, I'm not playing the piano. Like, I can't. I never really learned it this much. But I just practiced this one single song. And in the beginning, to be honest with you, it looked impossible. Like, really impossible. Because it requires a huge distance between your fingers, stuff like that. But I got it, you know, with time. And same thing with drawing. So anyway, we have this basic structure. Light comes from the left, darkening the entire right side areas of this boaty here. And this is it, just another cool example. I think this line is a bit skewed. Should be like that, probably. Yeah, just another quick, cool example. And I think now we're moving on to the last one, okay? So you'll be happy to learn that the last example is actually the simplest. We're just looking at a boat from above. So we're just going to get that front area again. It's because it's the closest to us, it's the most obvious one. Again, a trapezoid like this. One line that's actually almost vertical. We have this weird angle because the boat is at an angle inside the water, I guess. So we have this kind of a weird thing going on. And now here, because we have foreshortening, we're not looking at the boat from the top, but rather at an angle, it becomes shorter. It gets more squeezed in the distance. So what we want to do is, again, measure the relations between this part and the rest. So I'm going to just quickly do that and try to understand if I can figure out. It looks like this top point is about 1.5 or twice as long as this line. So I'm going to just do 1 and a bit. I think maybe a bit more like that. So this is the edge point of this boat. Just going to draw the edge line indicating the end of it. And from that, I'm going to connect with the original line here. Now, an interesting thing happens because this line doesn't connect directly. It doesn't end at a horizontal, at a vertical angle. It comes from the left a bit, ever so slightly. So let's try and get that in. This is, I think, one of the more complicated lines to get in general when drawing. My voice is cracking. In general when drawing. So we have this like that, and here we have just the same thing, only a bit easier on this side. And we have two planks of wood, one here at the back and another one. This one should be a little larger. And another one here at the front. Look at this. And it's filled with water. So what happens is all the inside is a bit darker, actually, and is reflecting the sky. Now, of course, if I would use color, I'd have many more options to convey this. But I'm just doing it really as simple as I can with just a bit of shading here. Well, it really doesn't have to be that perfect. It's kind of clear from the context. And yeah. The only thing I kind of forgot is to leave room for the sides of the boat. So it's something like this. Yeah. Okay. I think this one is close enough. There are, of course, a bit more details. You have this another plane going like this, some of the wood of the structure. But just in terms of the general structure of it, this is what it looks like. And the shadow on the water, or the reflection, it's kind of half a shadow, half reflection, sort of goes like this at an angle here. And you get this very, you see this, you know, the details. You can sit really closely, use a more smooth paper for starters, because it's much better, and really get all of them in. But the general shape, the ability to portray the three-dimensional shape, that's, I think, the most important ability when talking about this, about drawing anything three-dimensional. Okay, let me zoom out for a second. Okay, guys, so I was kind of struggling getting a good angle with the tripod, so I decided to do some handheld action for you, like I like to do from time to time. Here we have all of the examples together with my dirty, disgusting towel for watercolor in the background. Anyway, we have all of the examples we looked at. This one smeared almost completely. Anyway, I hope this was helpful, and let's wrap up the video.
Anyway, this is it, friends. Let me know if this video was helpful. I sometimes like to try something a little different, and you see I just blasted through like 7 examples of how to draw these boats, and just went really light on them instead of going deep on every example. I think it's beneficial to once in a while, it can really help to show also one very detailed work, and sometimes more of a general approach. So anyway, this is it. In my course, this is exactly what I talk about, like how to view something, see it as it is, and portray it on paper. Even if you don't have a lot of experience, even if you don't have a lot of past experience with like pencil or pen or any specific tool, you're kind of just remember you were once drawing and stuff like that. Really, the visual aspect of it, being able to improve your visual perception skills, that's, I think, the real key. So anyway, this is it. If you enjoyed, subscribe to my channel, follow me on Snapchat and Instagram. I post really cool stuff there. Today I did like something really cool for the first time, but I guess you'll have to go there and see in order to know. So anyway, this is it. I'll see you again in another video really soon.